arrived into India. I was so super tired. And my airport pickup for the hostel should be here, so it's great. So I don't have to find a cab. And let's see what the weather is like. This is winter time here. It is a bit chillier than usual, of course. The temperatures apparently are around like 13 degrees Celsius, so it's not so bad. So let's see how it is. Once it's better than Canadian winters, I'm good. So I'm finally well rested and recovered from all that jet lag. So yesterday was a lot on the go, to be honest. I have a story time about the airport pickup. And just traveling for 2 days, that was a lot in itself. And then to deal with the whole airport pickup thing was just another layer to just me just feeling overwhelmed and tired and all that kind of stuff. And then when I got in my hostel, the room wasn't ready, so I had to wait another few hours. So once I got my room, I tried to sleep, couldn't. So I got dressed to try and like go around the town. I need to find an ATM. And then I found one, but I wasn't really in the mood for like exploring anymore. So I came back and I finally like started to get a bit sleepy. So I was thinking, okay, maybe I will go take a nap for a bit and then wake up, because there's like this karaoke night going on last night. So I would have wake up, like I had plans to like wake up for it. It was like at 9 or so, and I went for a nap probably like 3 p.m. But I never got up till like 11 p.m. I was just so done, like I was just so tired, like all my clothes were still on, everything. So at that point I got up 11 p.m., put on my pajamas, and then went straight back to bed. Now I'm up again. It's like 6 or 7 o'clock, I think. I'm waiting for my sister and my brother-in-law to come. But yeah, yesterday was just a lot, and I really think I needed like a good long nap to just recover from everything that happened yesterday. So they're probably gonna be feeling the same, because they're coming from London and then they got a connecting flight through. Yeah, so they're probably gonna be feeling the same because they're coming from London. No, actually, they're coming from Manchester. Then they had to catch a flight to London. Then they had to catch a flight to Finland and then to here. So they're probably gonna be just as jet lag as I was. And I've been talking to the right pickup driver, so hopefully they don't end up in my same situation. So yeah, hopefully today I go do a little bit more exploring, because yesterday was just like I was done with it. I just need to rest and recover. So let's see how today goes.
So look who has arrived in India.
Money bay.
World renowned.
Yes, world renowned. Travelers.
You don't know about that.
So we're going on an old heritage walk to go see some sights and try some street food. We had to cover our heads. We just came off the train. We're in Old Delhi at the moment.
Right?
On our way to Taj Mahal and Agra Fort, or Fort Agra, whichever one it is. Right now, the weather is really rainy, actually. So I'm hoping that it cooperates, at least so we can get a good view or potentially sunset. So we have a 3-hour ride. And to solve our border problems, we're doing the game. Trivia game.
Okay, where has the post office moved?
Who knows? My mother said, I would have found that out when I come because I would have gone to the old one. Jenny, we take 10 minutes on your time, on your section. Taj Mahal, but as you can see, it's raining so much right now.
We call mosaic.
Oh, mosaic. Yeah.
Green called malachite from South Africa. Black is onyx from Belgium. Red one is a coral from Yemen, and yellow one is tigray from Sri Lanka.
Wow.
All the stones come in the rock, then they cut the slices. When people rotate the wheel, then it becomes the shape. Then they fix it here. When they fix it one time, it's for forever.
Oh. Okay. Okay. That's nice.
This is a natural color stone. Even one of the expensive stone.
I would think so.
Now this is like that. But now we have a generation of the workers, they are doing the same kind of work.